In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can show Twitter feed on our WordPress website. So let me first show you how it looks. So we are going to use the social feed block from the Plus Addons for Gutenberg, and there we have an option for Twitter feed. And using this, we would be able to showcase our Twitter feeds something like this in this grid format. Or maybe we can show them in form of Masonry layout. Or maybe we can create a beautiful carousel like this one. So if that sounds interesting and you also want to show Twitter feed on your site, then hop in and I'll show you everything step by step. My name is Ankit Sharma from the team PostAmit, and if you want to deep dive in the world of WordPress using Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So let's dive in our WordPress backend and see how we can get these Twitter feed in our site and what customization we can do with that. So here we are in our WordPress backend, and here if we go in the plugin section, here we have the Plus Addons for Blog Editor Free as well as the Pro version. And once we have installed both of these plugins, we can now go to the Plus settings and then click on Plus Blocks. And here we need to search for social feed. So this is the social feed block that we are going to use. And as you can see, it's part of the Pro plan of this plugin. So make sure you have the Pro plugin installed. And once that is done, just turn on this block from here and then click on save. So now we are ready with our social feed block. So let's go ahead and create a page and see how we can use this social feed block to add our Twitter feed. So here we have a sample page and we have a big banner on the top, and at the bottom of this, let's go ahead and start by adding a row. So we will choose TP row block from here. And now we will choose single column layout. And here we will search for TP social feed. So this is the social feed block that we are going to use. So let's click on this. And right now we don't see any Twitter feed here. So in order to get our tweets listed here, we need to do some settings. So for that, we need to come down here in this layout section, and under content feed, right now it is selected to grid and we have some styles here. So we are going to cover that once we have some tweets here. So for that, we need to come down to this content section, and here right now it is selected as Facebook. We can change that to Twitter, and for rest of the others, we have created a separate video. So you can go ahead and watch our complete playlist. We will link that in the I button above. So if in case you want to add feed from all these social media platforms, you can easily do that by using this block. But right now we will select Twitter, and here it's asking us few information. And in order to get all of this detail, we need to log in the Twitter developer account. You can directly go to the Twitter developer website, or simply you can use this link here. Open that in a new tab, and this is going to take you to developer.twitter.com. So this is the dashboard of your Twitter developer account. So if this is your first time, you might need to fill up few forms here so that you can get your developer account ready. These are all just very straightforward forms, and you can easily fill that up. And once that is done, you will be able to see a blank dashboard. And now in order to create a new app, you need to go to Projects, Overview, and here on the right hand side, you will find a button, Add App. So we need to click on that. And here we need to click on Create New. And here in the app environment, we need to choose Production. And then click on Next. Let's give it a name. So this will be our app name, and then click on Next. So here are the various API keys and secret key for our Twitter app. So make sure you copy all of this information from here and keep that in a safe place. So here we will first enter our consumer API key. So let's do that. And then we will enter our API secret. And then we will enter the access token, and then our token secret. And as soon as we enter this information, we see that our user feed is generated here. So let me just go ahead and publish this page right here and see how it looks in the front end. So here we have our page, and at the bottom we have our Twitter feed showing here. So now after adding all this basic information, we can now play around with the style. So we can go on the top. Here we have the layout option. We have grid, masonry, or maybe we can create carousel. So this is how we can create a slider from our tweets, or maybe we can play around with the style. So you can change the look like this, but I would prefer the first one. So we will go with that. Along with that, if you want, you can add one more social feed here. So maybe you can add another social feed and choose Facebook and show your Facebook feed here. So there will be two different social feed right here in one single page. And how you can show this multiple feed, we have also covered that in a separate video. Again, you will find the link of that video in the I button above. Now here, if we choose Twitter, let's scroll down. And here the first option is user feed. And above this, we have user timeline. So if we select that, it will show the timeline of the current user. Or maybe we can enter a username here like PoseyMyth. So this is going to show the user timeline of this particular Twitter handle. If we change that to user feed, you will be able to see the user feed of this particular Twitter handle. Along with that, if you select user likes, so you will be able to see all the tweets that this particular user liked on Twitter. In the same way, we can have tweets list and tweets collection. So how this one works, for that we need to open a new website. So this is tweetdeck.twitter.com, and here you can create your list and collections. So let's first talk about list. So here I have already created a custom list as well as a custom collection. So in order to add a custom list, all you have to do is just click on add column, and here you can create a list, and here you can create a list, and then you can give it a name, description, and that column will be added here. For example, I have already created this list here. And if I want to add more tweets into this list, all I have to do is just click on this three dots icon here on any tweet, and then click on add or remove from list. So if I click here, this will be added to my Woo list. So let's click done here. So now my list got a new tweet here. Now how we can show this in our WordPress site? For that, we need to click on this setting icon here. And here we have a share option. And then click on embed timeline. Now if we scroll on the top, here is the ID of this particular list. So let's come back here, and for tweet list, here is the list ID option. Let's paste it here. Now I can see the tweets in my list showing up here. Now I can show or hide media. So this is how it's going to look. And we also have an option to show retweets as well. In the same way, we can change this to tweets collection, and we need to enter a collection ID here. So let's come back here in our tweet deck. And we already have a WP feed collection. Once again, we will click on this setting icon, click on share, and then click on embed. And again, we will copy the code for this collection. Let's come back in our page editor. And in the same way, we now see the tweets from that particular collection. Again, we can show or hide the media and show or hide the retweets. Now after collection, we have tweets by search. And here we can enter a search term like Gutenberg. So all the tweets with this search term will be available here. Now you can change the result type here. So right now it is mixed. You can change this to recent, or maybe you can change this to popular. After this, we have tweets trends. So here we need to enter a WOEID code. So for that, we need to go to findmycity.com, and here they have a new website. Let's click on this. And it's called WOEIDs.com. And here we can choose any of the place, let's say New York. And this is the WOEID for New York. Let's copy this and let's paste it here. So this is what's trending in this particular place. After this, we have retweets by me. So here it will show all the retweets done by the Twitter profile. And you can also show custom tweets as well. So here we need to enter the tweet ID. So for that, we need to just go to any particular tweet. And here in the URL, we get the ID. And let's come back here and then paste the tweet ID here. So now you can see we have this particular tweet showing in our feed. And we can enter multiple tweet IDs here, separated by comma, and then create our own custom tweet feed. So let's come back to user feed to show the Twitter feed of our username Posimit. And here we can give this a category name. So let's call it Twitter. And this category can be used for creating filters for this feed. So this one is useful if in case you are showing multiple feed on single page, so that you can add categories on top of it for filtering. And with that, you can filter out which feed you want to see. And how it's done, we will check that in just a few minutes. Now after checking out all these options, we can now go to social feed option. And here we have backend on, so that's why we see these tweets in the backend. If we turn this off, we won't be able to see anything here. Right now it is set to 100. You can set it as per your requirement. Below this we have media filter. So here it is set on default, but you can hide all the media content, or maybe you can just show only media content. So right now let's keep it on default. Below this we have show title. So this one is only applicable for video format. So this will be only for YouTube, Vimeo and Instagram mentions. So it's not applicable in this case. After this, we have display ID and exclude. So if we turn this on, here you can see we have a unique code added with each of these tweets. So if in case we don't want to show this tweet in our feed, so all we have to do is just copy this code from here, paste it here, and then update your page. After this, we have filters. And this is the category wise filter. If we turn this on, here we can see all category or Twitter. So this Twitter text is coming from here that we have entered on the top. Now if you add one more social feed and add a category to it, so this is very helpful if you have multiple social feed and you want to create a filter with. So if you have Twitter, Vimeo, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, so all that can be added in one single page, and you can use these categories as filter that will show on the very top. So right now we are only showing Twitter, so we can turn this off. After this we have lazy load. So right now it is set to none, but if we want, we can add load more button here to see more, to load more tweets in this feed. Or maybe we can have a lazy load option so that once we scroll down, it will keep on loading more posts. And once again, we can customize all the text and things related to the load more as well as lazy load. Below this, we have column manager. So right now it is set to 3 column, and you can change that to 6, 4 or any number of column depending upon your website theme. But right now 3 column looks decent. And after this, you can change the gap between these columns from here. And then we have extra option. So here we have refresh time, which is set to 1 hour. So after every 1 hour, the API from our website will connect with the Twitter server and then try to fetch the new tweets. But this one can put a lot of burden on our website server. So instead of 1 hour, we can set this to 1 day. So this fetching of new tweets will only happen in 24 hours. And after this, we have text limit. So here, if we turn this on, right now it is set on characters. We can set this on word as well. And then we can limit the number of words to 6. So here you can see the text is now hidden after 6 words or maybe 5. And after this, we have the show more option, which again we can customize. So instead of show more, maybe we can just have more. And with that, we have this display dots. So these are the 3 dots after our text. So again, we can hide or show them. Now after this, we have on post click. So what should happen if someone clicks on any of these tweets in our feed? So right now it is set to do nothing. We can choose go to website, so it will go to that particular tweet, or it can open a fancy box. So if we update this here and refresh our front end. So if I click on this tweet, it's going to open this light box here. And once again, we can scroll through our tweets right from this light box. After this, we have curl SSL verify peer. So right now this option is set to on, but if in case you are developing this site in a local server which does not allow secure connections, then you need to turn off this option. But once the website is running on a live server, make sure you turn this option on so that the API and the server from where we are fetching all this feed will have a secure connection. Now after this, we have performance option. Now this one is the best part about this block. Here if we turn on this option, now whatever customization and settings we have done here will now get saved in our database. Now whenever a visitor lands on this feed page, they will get the first information from our database, not from the Twitter server. Now with this, whenever this page loads, the API don't have to be in contact with the Twitter server to fetch all these feed. But just in case, if you edit any of these settings here, then you need to clear up the database and save the new information. So for that, first we need to turn off this performance option. Then we need to delete all transients. So this is going to clear the database, and then we need to turn the performance option back on so that we can save the new information in our database. So all these options can improve your website speed and performance very well. Now once we are done with all these settings, we can now jump onto the style tab. And with this, we get all the options that we need to style our social feed. Right now, the first option is universal. So this one is only applicable if you are using more than one social feed. So with this universal styling, you can have a universal style to both of your feed. So they will have same title, same description typography and icon size. So this is going to give a consistent look to your feed. But just in case you want to have a unique look to all of your feed, let's say you want blue color for Twitter and maybe dark blue color for Facebook. So that can be done from here. We have a separate styling option for Facebook. We have a separate styling option for Vimeo, YouTube and Twitter. So let's say for Twitter, we want the background color to be something like a light blue. Something like this one. So all these tweets will have a light blue background. So this will actually create a unique look to all our content feed. And after this, we have styling option for fancy box. So that pop-up which opens up, you can style that as well. And after this, we have styling option for show more text and the lazy load option. So we can go ahead and style that. So here we can increase or decrease the size of this spinner. And we can change the width of the border. So this is how we can play around with all of these styles. So if we update this here and refresh our front end. So here we have our page, and at the bottom of this, we are showing our Twitter feed. So this is how easy it is to show Twitter feed on our WordPress website using the Plus add-ons for Gutenberg. And not just for Twitter, as mentioned before, you can show your Facebook, YouTube and Instagram feed right inside your WordPress website. If you want to learn how you can do that, you can watch our complete playlist that we will link in the I button above. So if you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button, and if you want to watch more videos about how you can do some amazing stuff using the Plus add-ons for Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So that's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.